السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. After finishing the Kurbani project, we went back to UK and we showed all our media material, photographs and meetings and others on our newsletters. And this has changed the atmosphere of the humanitarian atmosphere of organization working in Iraq without disclosing any information, without making any report and without making anything. It was a non-transparent system at that time. But alhamdulillah, we managed to do that and to break the taboo and bring this and make it to be actually, this is where we want, this is how we want, and this is how we distribute everything here and there. So all the Iraqi and other organizations started to follow our footsteps, Islamic League footsteps, and disclose and to go there and take the risk to make the reporting and show the photographs and the images. Our task for the second journey, which was supposed to be for July, August 1996, was to start to make a plan for cancer treatment or leukemia treatment for children. And we came back and we sat down with the Children's Hospital in Birmingham to make a program and a roadmap of what we need, the schedule of leukemia treatment in Iraq. And they wrote the schedule for us step by step. And we bought everything for the children. Needles, which at that time, all the needles and it was actually metallic one, and because there was injection was supposed to be to the bone at the back, and some of them. And this was forbidden to go to Iraq. Even sometimes to make life difficult for the Iraqi people, not the government, sending pencils was prevented because pencils inside, the pencil is the lid. And they said they can take the lid and make bullet out of it. What a joke. What a funny people. Anyway, so it took about us 2-3 months to make the schedule of the treatment. Not only that, we also bought a lot of detergent and cleaning material for the hospitals, for the all the general hospitals in all the districts of Iraq. So we had two trucks, one for the medicine to go to Iraq, and the other one for the detergents and the chemical and the cleaning material to go to Iraq as well. And then the second one, we put the share of each governorate there. You see, if I've got, I can't remember how many governorate in Iraq at that time, but from the time we left Baghdad by the truck, we know that every governorate will have its share to go to the general hospital for give them the detergent and the cleaning material. At that time, it was a big scandal for the what we call the international alliance, who were preventing any medical material to go to Iraq. So to buy this medicine for Iraq, at that time, we have to do the shopping. A lot of pharmaceutical companies refuse to send or to sell anything to Iraq. So we have to go to brokers, through brokers A, B, C, D, from outside. Of course, the state, the analysis, companies refuse utterly, and we have to go through European brokers to buy all this material. Thank God for this individual who managed, we managed to let him to give us up to $1 million at that time in 1996 to buy the detergents, the cleaning material, as well as the chemical material for the treatment for leukemia of the children. Here the message for us. Two messages. I failed to make induction to us, to Affan to come when he came with me as his first trip. And Affan was a very skinny man and he needed his breakfast. And I first time I skipped the breakfast in Rashid Hotel. Second day, third day, Affan told me, "Listen, I'm not going to move out unless I have my breakfast." The breakfast at that time was costing us 5,000 dinars, about $5-6. I listened to him and they started to eat my breakfast with him. I wanted to save this $10 or $12 every day, but he decided that. The second thing, I wanted to be kind to Affan as well by actually giving him a treat. So I took him to a place selling the heads, the legs, not the meat itself, but actually the heads, the brain and everything. And I wanted him to eat with me. He was nearly vomiting. He said, "What is this? I cannot touch it. I cannot eat it." Then I took him to our butcher who we used to buy sheep from him. And he made a big tray for him of every nice thing, kebab, kofta, ribs and others. And said, "Is this man going to finish it? Oh, I cannot believe it." Of course, he did not finish it. But I have to treat him nicely. Second thing, actually, not making induction to a volunteer or to a young officer in Islamic was another failure myself, because he was wearing the same kind of clothes like Aftab was wearing there. And I got the spray for his shoes, the spray for his socks, and. So my failure again of not making induction to the young people who used to come with me. Not everybody of them will be like me. So failed in the first with Aftab, failed in the second with Affan, failed with Affan again because I should have looked at his physical power and gave him more food and drink and water, not actually treating him like myself. Thank you very much. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.